Thanks for staying with us a few more minutes to talk about a story that we weren't able to cover in this week's show. KUNM reporter Ed Williams has been following a story for weeks now on a toxic dry cleaning spill under downtown Albuquerque. People who live and work on top of the spill haven't been notified about it, if you can believe it. Even worse, there's no plan right now to clean it up. Marisa DeMarco, how did your colleague get details about the spill in order to get to report on it in the first place, if nobody even knows about this? It's amazing.
This was a public record story.
Wow.
Ed made a lot of public records requests and dug through data and found this spill.
Wow.
Which is bigger than the Kirtland jet fuel leak.
Ouch.
And which is 35 feet below the surface and which has been known about since the 90s. And it's right under downtown Albuquerque.
The map was frightening.
A little bit north of downtown Albuquerque.
Right. In my understanding, from his reporting, it's a four-part series. It's actually great listening. I go to their website. You got to go to listen to this. But it's moving as well as these things move. And so we don't have monitoring wells. We don't have anything at this point going on.
Yeah. So it's in groundwater, mm-hmm. and it's in the ground itself. And there's discussion of whether it can evaporate up out of the ground and into the air and into people's homes, some of which are not necessarily built on top of concrete blocks.
Like
that's right. They're built directly on the earth.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's kind of the issue there. It's near Creamland Dairy. It's near Tractor Brewing Wells Park. And so the extent of what's going on down there isn't known, and what they're going to do to clean it up isn't known. And the New Mexico Environment Department actually said that it could become a Superfund site, which is, of course, a concern for everybody who lives in the area.
You know, speaking of Tractor Brewing, Sophie Martin, brilliant quote from the woman that during Ed's reporting, that she didn't know about that when they bought the building.
Yeah,
something profoundly unfair about that. Something could be a potential Superfund site.
That's right.
And
that's
you don't know?
It's a big issue. And
I
think...
Or not told, I should say.
I think that her concerns are really valid for many businesses in that area. You know, Wells Park has been undergoing a real renaissance lately.
That's right.
And it, certainly since the time that the Environmental Department knew about the spill, the business that is responsible for the spill has done a little bit, but not very much.
That's right.
And we hear from the Environment Department that they're waiting for the company to come back to them with a plan. This seems like a broken process.
There you go. 4 years on, it seems, for this plan we're waiting from this company. Are they still in business? Nobody even, you know.
Yeah, I don't know. When you're hearing this report,
these
are the questions I have. What's going on here? And I think this is also hurts the economic development, because this is an area that's been promoted.
That's right.
This is an up-and-coming area. This is a new Albuquerque.
Right.
Now, with this here, I mean, how does one even react to this?
That's right. That's right. With a lawyer, perhaps? I mean, if you know, to get things moving along, if you're a business owner and you were never told and not required to be told there was a toxic plume under your business, I got to think there's something going on here for an attorney to look at.
Well, where's Erin Brockovich when you need her?
Right, there you go.
I mean, I could see Sophie might bring her in. We could have a movie about Sophie Martin here pretty soon. She could be the new one that leads the charge on this.
There you go.
You know, it's interesting that this is affecting so many people.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's going to be interesting to see how this affects, you know, there's certain individuals that invested a ton of money in revitalizing downtown. Does this affect their investments? And those are the people with the ears of the politicians, you know, the checks that they're writing that say, I just spent $15 million investing downtown Albuquerque. That's now worth $6 million. It's a shame, but that's the kind of stuff that gets things going.
Right.
At the end of the day, you know, knowing that there's this giant plume moving down there, and you've got kids and families and businesses and homes, and nobody's done anything about this, and it takes a single reporter to go through an unbelievably lengthy process to break this story. It just begs the question of the trust in the government. At some point, somebody should have stepped up and said, "We got a problem."
Mm-hmm.
But you know, and you'd think at some point in New Mexico, when it's affecting groundwater, something we don't have a lot of in
this
state,
something that's
worth more. You know, as they said, you know, they fight over oil, they argue over beer, they'll shoot you over water. You know, this is something that's affecting that. You'd think there would have been more of a run to the forefront by somebody to say, we got to fix this.
Mm-hmm.
Shame on the government for not stepping up to take care of this.
Is it? I mean, never the government, it's never industry that does this. It's always,
frankly,
some person who then gets marginalized as an unwashed hippie, right? It's always the activist who comes forward or the journalist.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and so to say government should have done this, that's not what our government currently is built to do.
Mm-hmm.
Just one last thing that
Please.
I really want to mention, because I don't want the story to become more alarming than it is.
it
is in the groundwater, but the city's drinking water wells are not near the spill. So
gotcha.
I just want to make sure that
That's
everybody
important.
Knows
sure.
these toxins are not in your drinking water, as far as we know.
That's right.
But that's the
just,
question, as far as we know.
Well, but there's no drinking water wells within the.
But if we're not,
okay,
but if we're not, but here's the thing to remember though: if we're not monitoring it, We're not
sure. It hasn't been checked.
We're not sure what water gets to what wells into what groundwater. That's a huge argument down in southeastern New Mexico about, does the water on the Pecos get to the Ogallala Aquifer? Does it get somewhere else? Mm-hmm. I mean, when it comes to this water stuff, I do think, you know, we heard here anyway, I didn't know about the story until just now, mm-hmm. that we're waiting for the business to do something. So it seems to me like, you know, at some point somebody knew there was a problem, somebody went to this business, whether it was filing a claim in insurance, whether it was fining them, whatever it was, and then it just kind of quietly went away. And, you know, we had these problems, and the thing about the dry cleaning problems, these problems exist all over New Mexico. There's a huge problem down in Roswell with dry cleaning and the gas tanks. Both of those, you know, the old gas tanks that were buried in the ground that have leaked, the gas stations. And what's interesting is you're finding out in a lot of these places, the gas stations were right next door to the dry cleaners.
That's right.
And together, it's created an unbelievable cocktail for the community.
You were in the legislature when the Lust Act was approved. I seem to remember it. Was that during your time, getting rid of all the Lust Act? Yeah, I forget what the acronym stands for. It was getting rid of the tanks underground. You mentioned the gasoline tanks.
Yeah, pulling the tanks out.
Yeah, that was during your time. Yeah. I seem to remember. There's a lot of activity. We're going to have Ed Williams on, hopefully, at some point soon to talk about this. There's so many details about this, and I really tip my hat to him. Really good stuff. Thank you all for this Web Extra. Really appreciate it.